And the hummingbird has a very long neck. You might not notice that it could be extended like that. The shoulder is very important. There's a space between the neck and the white space between the head and the shoulder. Okay. Normally we don't see the hummingbird's feather, but if you paint that, it will be like so. This is the muscle, a very short bone and muscle. The feather goes like this long.
Okay.
Yeah, so this is all are very in the motion. You don't really see the blurry. Only
the
this little, yeah. Only this little. A hummingbird doesn't have the elbow, so it goes like that. But it goes like circles. So it can fly backwards. Hover. So that's very different than any birds. So when I paint that, I will use let's say the color I will use is green, service. Wrong, point it on. You can use the opaque green if you want. I think let's just do this. Yeah, you can use this green. Let's just practice a little bit. So this is the color. Okay, this is another thing I need to mention. This is the forehead should be kind of flat, not rounded. Many of my students do a head like that.
Oh.
Yeah, this is too much. This should be flat like that. Most birds don't have that brown. Although the hummingbird is very smart with a large brain and large heart too, but it's a very flat top. And then the chest and the belly. Okay. You might use, maybe we use gray to start with. The chest has a little shiny red or something. That's a characteristic. So I'm going to do a flying one. Do the chest first, use some gray to start with. Yeah, just a dot of this gray. And the tail and back should be like half oval, and then a dot, like the calligraphy dot we learned for the head,
okay.
Just a little point.
Finding you need a lot more ink or color on this type of paper.
Yeah.
That doesn't show.
Yeah, you're supposed to do it in several steps in Gombe, but you need to use pure color, right? You're right. And we can do this one fine. Let's see if I can do it. So the shoulder actually lower than this, the neck. Okay, I just do a little dark, and then I'll use this clean brush to pull it, maybe a little gray, purple, something. poet to create, I mean to the motion blur. Okay, you can consider the shape of that. You need to paint. I think I will do it like the knife, like a.
Oh, like a blade.
Blade, yeah, blade shape is around it. On this side. It's very light, very light. So let me make it clear so you can see the blade shape. As I said, this is very long. It's very long, almost like the body and the body and the tail combined. Then the other side should be a little in a perspective. You know, it could be shorter. So just suggestively, I use the clean brush. Just watch it. Suggesting on the other side, and use a stiff brush to draw the beak. You know? I dotted the eye first, and then the beak. A little curve. Okay.
I should have watched. Did you go outside in or inside out?
Oh, it doesn't matter. You can repeat it. On this paper, it's really okay. You can dot some pattern on the neck. The dark throat version only have dark. On the male, you know, female has only the dark spots. The male in the mating season may display some red, very characteristic. For that, you can prepare with dark dots, and then add orange color or vermilion to this. It's like a little scale kind of shape for the red neck, red throat or red neck. The neck, the feet is very hidden, so it's just almost like, it's very, they don't walk, it's very underdeveloped, you know, very small, very weak, don't need to paint big claws or something like that. But the tail is very, tail is very important in the movement, and it could be, when it flies fast, it goes and it will fend when it stops.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, so we can make it fend and look, you know, like that. That's my observation of the hummingbird. Okay, I got brown on the face. That's wrong. But that's cover up. When you make a mistake, you use an opaque color to change it. So that brown becomes the base. You can use this real opaque color to cover anything. And also on this dark base. Beginning of the tail, but that's too much. You can wash it off. Okay, and the body may have some white in it, so you can wash it a little bit. Just add a little white. The also used to color it, to color this too much. Okay. Let's just add the excitement of the vermilion color to the neck. And you can cover the ink as well. Well, my battery goes off, so that's all I can do for this demo. Okay, let's call it, yeah, that's my study of the hummingbird. And I'll show you the complete painting maybe later. But I will show Terry here, because my battery is going to die. I cannot see it.